Every tower in Bloons Tower Defense has its own unique ability, but let's be honest, you can get a little bit overwhelmed if you get every single tower and every single ability. I mean, there's like 15 abilities on screen and then everything's going crazy and you have to be pushing all these buttons and it's just sometimes too much. So in today's mod, created by doombubbles, by the way, huge shout out to you, we are going to be taking abilities, and instead, when you get an ability on a tower, you have the opportunity to forego that ability and instead get a new permanent effect on the tower. For example, if you get the Dartland Gunner and you go the middle path, and instead of getting Hydra Rocket Pods, you now have the ability to have a permanent stream of the special Hydra Rocket ability, but just weaker. Is this gonna make the game easier, harder, or just crazy? I don't know, let's find out. And of course, we're always gonna be playing on a custom map because custom maps are always just super duper fun. I actually really like this map. This map seems super fun. So we basically wanna use only ability-based towers. That's it, nothing else. I only wanna get towers that have abilities so we can see what the abilities do. So the tag shooter, we need to go and get the blade shooter, and we need to get the blade maelstrom ability, which costs $2,000. Do we want faster? I think we want more tacks. I feel like having just a bunch of tacks that get sent out is definitely the play here. And I think that, I mean, the blade maelstrom's actually kind of good. It's like kind of good. It's not like really good, it's just kind of good. But the thing that makes the blade maelstrom or the middle path tack shooter so powerful is the ability. So my question is, what's gonna happen when we try to get the blade maelstrom? What is the special thing or ability that we're gonna get? The new passive that's added onto the tower. I think this is actually such a genius idea for a mod, and I'm really excited to try out pretty much all of the things that they have to offer. I kind of want to just save up and go straight for the blade maelstrom. I normally would just go for like a banana farm, but I think getting the blade maelstrom like right— no! No! There's one red balloon! Curse you, Perry the Platypus! How disrespectful of that one red balloon to get by. No, we can't have any more red balloons getting by. Don't tell me it's just one red balloon that's getting by. I can't believe it. Just one more red balloon got by? That is so sad. One like on this video equals one sadness. So let's upgrade it and see what happens. So, do you want to forego the Blade Maelstrom ability to instead get more range and pierce and Blade Seek out balloons? Yeah, I do want that. Holy cow, look, it actually seeks out balloons now, like the Shuriken ability. That's so overpowered. So I don't have the ability, so I actually can't use Blade Maelstrom anymore. But it just seeks out balloons. So it's like a permanent Blade Maelstrom, and look at the range that it has. That's bonkers! And it can go past walls and stuff too. Okay, that's kind of overpowered. Oh no! I can't put a banana farm here! Oh, that is so sad! This tower is just gonna pop everything forever. Literally, that, like, look at how powerful it is! I love this mod. This mod is amazing. Now, this is gonna be like one of the only times I'm actually going to upgrade to get the IMF loan, because I would love to see what the bank is gonna do with IMF loan. Like, because normally the ability, it allows you to generate $10,000 in cash, but you go $10,000 into debt. And so what kind of, is it just gonna make it a better bank? Because if that's the case, I'm all about a better bank. Look at this. Balloons are getting down here, all the way down here, and they're still getting popped. Do I want to get multiple banks or just save up for one IMF loan? I think I'm gonna save straight up for the IMF loan. Okay, what is the next ability that I want to get? Well, we can't hit camo balloons right now, so that is a problem. What does the ninja? There's balloon sabotage. What is balloon sabotage gonna do? It's $5,000. Let's get balloon sabotage. I really, really want to find out what that's gonna do. So I'll put you down, and let's get sharp shurikens, distraction, counter espionage, shinobi tactics, which cost almost $1,000. I didn't know shinobi tactics were so expensive. Holy cow, that's burning a hole in my wallet. And now we need to get balloon sabotage to see what this crazy ability is going to do. We have to deal with lead balloons next round. I'm scared. I don't know what to do. I don't know how to deal with lead balloons. Let's get a bomb shooter. We're gonna put a bomb shooter right here. Target strong. Are we gonna get all of them? Let's get faster reload. Okay. Oh, this isn't good. This is not good. This is not good. I need to collect all. And let's just put down this dart monkey right here. And I'm just going to get triple shots real fast just so we can pop a majority of the balloons so we don't lose a ton of lives. That was 57 lives we stopped us from losing there. I know I said I was going to actually invest and buy myself one of these, the IMF loan, but since I had to take the money out a little bit prematurely just because the lead balloons got by because I wasn't prepared. Bigger bombs. I definitely... Every tower, by the way, we're going to go the ability route just because the whole point of this mod is to change the abilities. So I definitely want to see all of the abilities that we have to offer. We almost have to deal with a Moab. We're very close to having to deal with it, but I want to save up and just get Bloom Sabotage. I know it's probably not a great idea. This thing is crazy. I want to see what Super Maelstrom does eventually, but right now it's doing great. Let's get Balloon Sabotage, because, all right, let's see what this does. So, do you want to forego the Balloon Sabotage ability to instead get Ninja's attacks, have more range, and slow down balloons themselves? Yeah, I'll definitely do that. That seems really good. So now he can just, any balloon he hits will just passively slow it. So now he's literally a Ninja Monkey and a Glue Monkey at the same time, which seems very, very crazy. We are going to need to deal with this Moab, so maybe we go and get the Moab Assassin. Because that is an ability, but I'd love to see what it does against, like, Moab class balloons, right? Like, that seems so. Moab Assassin, and so instead, does even further increased Moab damage. So now it's just, in no ability, it just does Moab damage. So let's see exactly how much damage this guy can do to a Moab class balloon. It's round 39. The first Moab's gonna show up next round. Let's see what this thing does. I'm actually really excited here. And... we're so close. Come on. Okay. Holy cow. Here we go. It's like a sniper, bro. It does so much damage. That's bonkers. Okay, let's collect all. Let's get IMF loan. So what does IMF loan do? So instead get maximum capacity is $17,000. Holy cow. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. That is so overpowered to have the maximum capacity $17,000. I'm about it. All right, what is the next ability? Do we want to just, like, go down the line? We can get Super Monkey Fan Club, which is $8,000. I'm about it. So let's get Super Monkey Fan Club. We can put, like, let's put Super Monkey Fan Club right here. So very quick. All right, triple shot. Super Monkey Fan Club's a little expensive. I definitely want to get long range and enhanced eyesight as well. $11,000 in the bank. And look at how much money we're going to get at the end of this round. Because remember, it's 15%. So if you have more money that's allowed in your bank, you're able to make so much more money. For those of you that missed out, we actually did a mod where we took away the entire limit of the bank and it could stack indefinitely. And by the time we had like $1 million in the bank, we were actually making like $100,000 every single round. It was really crazy. Okay, there's $30,000. So do you want to, so it said gains permanent super attack speed and range itself. Oh, so now it just, holy cow. So it becomes a super monkey basically. Look at that. Okay, that's amazing. So let's go ahead. We can put down a turbocharge monkey over here as well. I kind of want to just like put more and more down just to see what they do, right? So the turbocharge is the instead get smaller, but a constant attack speed buff. Yeah, I'm about that. Improve rings and glaives. That seems really, really strong. We have the bomb shooter. I wonder what ice monkey does. Here, we can put an ice monkey down right here. Larger radius, refreeze, and then we can get arctic wind and then snowstorm. So... instead, partially slows Moab class balloons. So now it just, look at that. Look at how slow it makes the Moab class balloons. Plus the stack with the Ninja Monkey, that's just a passive slow that's always going to be added on, which is really, really amazing, honestly. Okay, what about Monkey Buccaneer? Let's go ahead and get Monkey Pirates. So instead, cannon attacks significantly increase Moab and ceramic damage. Nice. And then let's put that on strong then. That seems really good. So basically, it kind of gives it a similar ability. Wait, so how does like the monkey ace work then? How does ground? So occasionally drops miniature ground zeros? Look at that. It literally just always drops ground zeros. Okay. Yeah, that seems reasonable. Like it's literally just randomly drops a ground zero. That's overpowered. That is so overpowered. You can't convince me otherwise. That is really strong. What is the helipilot? Support Chinook? What in the world is a support Chinook gonna do? Let's find out what the helicopter does. Okay, so pursuit and then support Chinook. So always gives one crate at the start of each round. So every round we just get a free crate? Oh my gosh. So you can still move towers. That's right, I forgot it gave you multiple abilities. So you can still move towers like normal, but instead of having the ability, just every round you get a free crate. Okay, I like that a lot. I think that's a really good ability. Wait, what is Jungle's Bounty gonna do? Let's put Jungle's Bounty over here. And let's level up and get Jungle Bounty. So ability, instead get 200 per round, nearby income increased by 15%. That's crazy. That's bonkers. That's really bonkers. So this just makes everything worth more money. Like, look at that, we have $26,000 in these banks. And we're getting more money from the this thing. It's already made us $3,000 and we have 234 lives. That's a lot of lives. I like that. So Spike Storm. So launches a continuous stream of spikes across. So it just always puts spikes down everywhere. Okay, I'm about that. All right, look at the, wait. Shouldn't that be 1750? Or does it max out at 1850? Look at that. It's still going. Didn't it say the max was 17,500? 20,000? And max is at 20,000? That's a lot of money. We have $60,000 now. How does overclock work? Wait, what does overclock do? So, modified ability. Permanently boost based on tier one tower at a time. So, it like permanently boosts it. Interesting. Well, now I also want to get a village. Because I would love to see like what a village does, right? So bigger radius, jungle drums. And what does call to arms do? So permanent weaker nearby attack speed buff. So basically every tower just is permanently attacking faster. That is nasty. And now we have to try out the dartling gunner. I wish I could put a dartling gunner right there. I guess I'll put the dartling gunner right here. So we definitely want to get laser shock and then hydro rocket pods, rocket storm. So shoots rocket storm missiles alongside the main track. Look at, what the heck, yo! Okay, I'm about it. All right, well, we can just log that in place there. And then, yep, okay, that's reasonable. That looks so cool how it shoots like the one rocket storm ability alongside of it. First strike capability. So what is first strike capability? Gain shriek and first strike style missile attacks. So, I mean, we'll take that, right? We're at round 74. We almost have every ability. What ability are we missing? We're missing sniper. Which is going to be supply drop. Always gives one crate, so it's the same. So one crate at the start of the round. We'll take that. More crates are always a bonus. We need to make sure that we get this character as well. Set target right there. And what ability? It's the top hat. Artillery. No, pop and all is so expensive. All right, pop and all. So occasionally causes mini and pop and all effects on targets. All right, we'll take that. That's pretty reasonable, I think. All right, we can sell these because it's pretty much... No, we have $40,000. Glue Monkey, we definitely want the Glue Monkey ability. So, main attacks apply weakening ability glue. Yeah, we definitely want that. Main attacks apply weakening slower ability glue. Alright, I love that ability. And this thing, we never got more range pierce and lifespan. So, I definitely want to get that because that's just like really, really cool. Did we miss any? We didn't get the Super Monkey. We didn't really do much of like any of the magic tier. All right, let's sell like everything over here. I know we have a lot, but I really want to see what the super monkey's like, right? So super range, epic range, tech terror. Frequently does a weaker version of the annihilation ability. Oh my gosh, so it just like pulses with the annihilation ability. Okay, that's really, really good. Alchemist, I guess it's just gonna be always in transforming tonic, right? So has permanent but weaker transforming laser attack. That probably makes it way better in my opinion. And then wizard. All right, let's put down the wizard. Here, we can sell this. We can sell this. We can sell like a lot of these. And now we can go and get the Wizard Lord Phoenix. So summon Phoenix. Phoenix is permanent. Yes. Wizard Lord Phoenix. Super Phoenix is also permanent but weaker. So now we just have two Phoenixes just always going along. Just always doing its thing, flying and just being absolutely bananas. All right, we'll take it. What has the most pops? The Monkey Ace. What is this? 37,000. I mean, this super monkey's doing really, really well too. Elite sniper always gives one crate. Yeah, so the crate ones basically just guarantees. Oh my gosh, that was a zone Z and now it's gone. That was amazing. If you enjoyed this mod, please hit the like button, subscribe, turn on notifications. I had a lot of fun filming this video and trying out all the different things. So thank you so much for watching. Have a great rest of your day, everyone. And I'll see you tomorrow for some more awesome content. Bye.